everybody. Corey Macklin here with Dave Brown, and we are just about set to go with another day of USWA Championship Wrestling. We got a wall-to-wall crowd here today, and get ready.
Full house today and a full card today. Great show we've got. Flamboyant Eric Embry, he's going to be out here today. Dr. Death and that nurse Kratchet with that bedpan, I'm sure she'll have that thing out here. Also, Young Gun is on the card. The Moondogs with Richard Lee. We'll have to put up with them right here.
Yep.
Cheering for the Moondogs. The Moondog fans are here today. And we'll see the Fat Boy and Dr. Tom Pritchard going against Brian Christopher and Tony Falk. That'll be a good tag team bout.
Absolutely. Should be a great day today. When we come back, we're going to be talking a little bit about someone who will be returning. That's coming up. Is here right now, and before we really talk too much, I want to kind of refresh everyone's memory. We talked about someone who's coming back, talking about Tony, Dirty White Boy, who's coming back this week. Here's why he has to come back. Here's what happened about 3 or 4 weeks ago. Watch this match.
Some kind of green jump that he blew right in the face of Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony. Boy, that's bad. Tony hanging on there now. Stubbing Tony's toes. Tony's down. That's the bout. Turnpole.
Stab making the back out with a stretcher. Some medical help for Dirty White Boy. Tony Anthony.
And they
Tony Anthony injured a couple of weeks ago, but coming back this week, and Kim, I know you're glad.
Oh, Dave, I'm excited. He has been sitting at home watching this week after week, and watching what Eric Embry is coming out here doing and everything. And like I said, he's ready to come back. And Eric Embry, I feel real sorry for you. Because he's going to tear you up.
I can imagine. Knowing Tony Anthony, and I can imagine how horrible it's been for him to sit there and just have to watch. And being able to get back into the action, he's got to feel good.
Oh, he's, like I said, he's ready to come back. He wanted to be here today, but he couldn't. He's got to wait a few more days before he comes back. So, like I said, I am real excited, and I'm ready for him to come back.
Well, I'm sure you. As a matter of fact, I think we're all ready to see him back here. About the only one, I guess, who would not be ready to see him come back would be, and here he comes, Eric Embry right here.
Eric.
Eric's got a match coming up now. Eric, we've got your match coming up. We'd like to finish.
She comes out here week after week, you know, and she talks about how obnoxious, what a piece of garbage I am and all that. But you're a man. You know, you can read between the lines of a woman. You know what she's actually saying is that she wishes that she could be my dirty white girl. You know what she's actually saying? You're actually out here saying week after week that you wish I'd just come out here and give you a big kiss or something, aren't you? Huh?
You are the nastiest piece of garbage I've ever saw in my life.
That's what
you can
saying.
Take 50
You're
shots.
Saying you want a big kiss, don't you? Big kiss. Embry.
I think it's rather apparent that that's not exactly what she's saying.
She just said she liked it and wants it again, Dad.
She did not. Come on, Embry. Come on, Kim.
Tony's gonna what?
Leave her alone.
Tony's gonna what?
He's gonna kill you when he gets back.
You know what she just said? You can't, you're a man. You can read, but that she said she wants me to do it again.
She did not. She wants you to leave her alone. Come on. Come on, Embry.
Hey, now I want to tell you something.
Well, you're not telling me anything. That's the most ridiculous thing I ever saw. The first time should have been enough for you to understand what you were saying. You've got a match. Suppose you get in the ring. I'm not talking to you out here. You can either get in the ring or get out of here. Either one. I don't care.
Boy, that's bad.
That Eric Embry, he's something else, Davey.
Well, cowboy mentality, I guess.
If that's what
the
it
word.
Is.
That's not even a good word. I mean, I hate to even characterize it as anything like that because that's not. It's just ridiculous. I mean, for heaven's sake, the woman said what she meant, and he pays no attention. I tell you what, I'm going to make sure Tony Anthony sees that videotape. Eric Embry better watch himself this week. Because if Tony weren't mad enough, she didn't like it, Eric Embry. That's it. He doesn't seem to even understand reality.
He's sickening, boy.
Find out about reality when Tony Anthony steps in the ring.
Well, Tony's going to take care of that. I guarantee you that. Tony Anthony may be at home watching that on today, but when he does get Eric Embry back in the ring this week, I guarantee you, he'll take care of Eric Embry. Embry working over Chris Frazier. Now, boy, that is something else. Came out here and just put himself over on Dirty White Girl. Now he's in the ring working over Chris Frazier. Now, Davey wants to know why we're so upset about the whole situation.
Well, he just doesn't understand, obviously, what's going on. I mean, she said, leave her alone.
Look at Big Frazier up there. He thinks he's really done something is what he thinks he's doing. She came out and kissed White Girl and then said, well, she wants me to kiss her again. Boy, that Embry, I tell you. Wrestling out of Dallas, Texas, Eric Embry. One fall, 15 minutes in time, working over Chris Frazier. Slams Frazier in the back. Picks him up now into the ropes. Oh, nails Frazier. Knocks him down with a big right hand there. Saying it was fun.
Yeah, he's having fun working over Chris Frazier. I'm sure he is. Frazier's having a very tough day. Doubled up right fist, nailed him right in the forehead with it.
Got him right upside the head, and Embry going for the pin cover. All there, two count out of the referee, Kevin Christian, telling him, you had the pin cover, that was two.
Yeah, he picked him up by the hair, too. Hair pulling, of course, is illegal anytime. Oh, yeah, now let's get nasty, he said.
Oh, working over Chris Frazier. Stumping on Frazier over, working him over there in the corner. Picks Frazier up. Setting him up now for DDT on Chris Frazier. That's the pin cover. 2-3. He got it now. 1-2-3. Now, Embry won the match. That's enough for him for today, I tell you. Boy, boy.
Well, he won the match. There's no doubt about it as he defeats Chris Frazier. I'm not talking to you, Embry. We're going to a break right here. I'm having nothing. You can just take it out of here. We'll be back. Last week, there was an incredible six-man tag team match. You had the Moondogs and Richard Lee in the ring going against the King, Jerry Lawler, Coco Beware, and their special partner, Kamala. Take a look at some of the highlights of that match.
Here we go! Coco! Working on Moondogs by Lawler outside of the ring on Fight Ho! And we're underway. Run for 60 minutes in time. Lawler's overworking on the Moondog. We're underway in this bout. That ironing board, he's got that thing bent over. Oh, and it goes over now. Scamalo's attendant with that thing. Moondog's got the timer's table that we had over here. Only got one. He's got it over there, choking Kamala with that. Working over Kamala. Meanwhile, if you look down here, Richard Lee's got Coco. Kamala with that garbage can. Boy, he's been working Kamala over tonight. Richard Lee comes over and slams Friday. Kamala's attendant working Friday over. Oh, he put the thought into Lawler's eyes. The King moved out of the way, and he got the Moondog with all of that blue powder. Ringing. I didn't even know.
no big black dog was in the arena. He's not scheduled to be here tonight. Wasn't even on their card. Richard Lee was the sixth man for the Moondogs.
Well, this incredible mayhem with everything that's not bolted down becoming an object that was used in the ring there, that six-man match. Now, coming up this week, there will be an eight-man tag team match involving many of the same folks, except this week, Coco Beware is not going to be one of the partners.
Yeah, Coco's manager didn't sit too well with him.
Kamala's manager said, I'm not going to have any of that, and here he is to, in his own way, explain why.
I'm not happy that my client, the Kamala, is teaming up with you, Jerry Lawler. You're nothing but a scumbag, Lawler. But you know, Lawler, you're paying us good money, and as long as the money's right, we'll hang in there. But there's things more important than money, and one thing is getting that belt back around Kamala's waist. And here's where we draw the line. We're not teaming up with Coco Ware. No way. There's things that are more important than money, and one of them is that. We are not teaming with you, Coco. You're nothing but a nappy-haired bum with a dirty chicken on your neck, and you stole the belt from us. And we know you're a good thief because you go around Memphis stealing hubcaps and purses. But we're not going to let you get away with stealing from us. You hear us, Coco? Coco, I promise you we're going to get that title back. And Laura, as long as the money's good, you're safe. But once it runs out, watch out.
Another one of those interviews filled with insults. Most of those insults directed at this man right here, Coco Ware. Get him over here and talk to him a little bit. Maybe he'll have a comment about what Kamala's manager had to say, and maybe he won't. Maybe he'll just talk about the situation coming up, because that unified world title is going to be on the line, as he will be defending it this time around. Coco, how's it going? Tell me about, I guess you heard that interview there.
Yes. Warrior! Oh, I'm telling you, I got the best crowd in town, baby. Look at Memphis over there. Ain't that right, baby? Oh, you see Lance, you see Dave Brown. Let me tell you one thing, brother. That's one thing I can't stand is a doggone no good manager like Kamala's got. You see, I never trusted Kamala at all, because you see, I knew something was going on. But let me tell you one thing, Kamala. When I came back to Memphis, I told everybody I was going to put Memphis on the map. And I did it, baby. I got the strap around my waist. Oh, yeah. But you see, now Kamala don't want to be my partner in the eight-man tag. Because you see, Jerry Lawler invited me to be a part of the eight-man tag because he knows that I'm a fighter. I'm not a quitter. So Kamala, what are we going to do, baby? We're going to have the title match. That's right, Monday night. We're going to have it. Because after it's all over, you won't be able to go back in that eight-man tag match. Because Kamala, I'm going to beat you. I'm going to beat all the black off your butt. And you, cue ball up in New York City, I'm going to kick you where the sun doesn't shine, and then your mama going to go around Memphis, Tennessee, around New York, stealing hubcaps. Because I'm telling you one thing, Dave Brown, baby. I'm bad. I'm super bad. And Kamala, bigger they are, harder they fall. Because I got something for you, baby, that Ajax won't take off. And that is a good butt kicking. And it goes for anybody else. Look like you, Kamala. And Dave Brown, I'm fired up about it, because I don't like this stinking what's going around here, because I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's happening. Kamala don't know what's happening. Nobody knows what's happening, but we will know what's happening Monday night, because that belt will be on the line.
Everything will be sorted out there. The unified world title on the line. Coco Beware going against Kamala. Back after this. With our next match, Frazier Thompson is in the ring right now. Frazier, after really coming on strong, has hit a streak of tough luck here recently. Dr. Death climbing up on the ring apron along with Nurse Kratchet.
Yeah, Frazier had a good winning streak going on there, Dave, and he's hit a tough stroke here lately, but maybe he'll pick it back up and get back up on his good foot.
Maybe this is the day. Going against tough competition in the form of Dr. Death, and You got to give Nurse Kratchet a big assist over here in the corner. She carries that bedpan around with her and has been known to bong people on the head with it.
I forgot.
They
got to get the gloves.
Yeah. Got to put the rubber gloves on here. The bell has sounded. Referee Frank Morrell is standing there going, anytime. Now she finally steps out of the ring, and it's Dr. Death against Freezer Thompson, and here's Corey Macklin.
Thank you, Dave. We're underway. One fall, 15 minutes in time, and Dr. Death slugs Freezer with a couple of right hands there, working on him now in the midsection. Really going out to Freezer, too.
By the way, I didn't mention, but at ringside, she just made an appearance third or fourth week in a row. She's been out here making notes. Last week, she revealed her name to be Lauren Davenport, and she's out here with clipboard and pen in hand. I don't know if she's making notes about Dr. Death or Freezer or what the situation is, but she's definitely here evaluating someone or something here today. Well, as a matter of fact, here she is right here. May I ask who you're checking out today?
Looking at Dr. Death. You've been talking about Dr. Death for the past couple of minutes. Have you even stopped to think about poor dirty white girl Kim? I guess that's just over. That disgusting pig comes out here and kisses on her.
Well, I think I pretty
outraged.
I was outraged, and I think I pretty fully expressed that opinion.
You look outraged. You make me sick.
What was that for?
I have no idea. But then I didn't understand what she was talking about last week either, so,
Boy, I tell you, you're talking about, a lot of strange people in the USWA. Dr. Death working over Freezer Thompson. Working Freezer over. Referee Frank Morrell trying to assist Freezer. Freezer back up on his feet. Dr. Death. So, big suplex. Boy, it takes a lot of power to do that on Freezer Thompson.
Boy, it sure does. Man as big as he is, it's not easy to get him off the mat at that high, especially. And he flipped him pretty easily. Dr. Death's got some good upper body strength. He just proved that right there.
Yes, sir, indeed. Dr. Death. Nurse Kratchet at ringside with a little assistance trying to... Oh, get the doctor. Boy, he... Caught Freezer. Big chop on Freezer Thompson.
Whoa.
Man, boy, you hear those things all over the studio. Dr. Death slugs Freezer with another right hand now. And Freezer Thompson has hardly been on his feet during this match. Dr. Death's been working him over. Got him over on the middle rope now. Better watch Nurse Kratchet over there. She nailed him. Oh, she caught him with that stupid bedpan. Oh, boy. He got the three count. With some assistance from Nurse Kratchet. Remember that. She came out here. She holds on to that stupid bedpan. And, boy, she clubbed Freezer right at the top of the head and laid him all the way out. Dr. Death gets the win.
She blasted him. And once again, it's Nurse Kratchet with the assist in the victory for Dr. Death. That seemed to become the pattern. I hope Lauren Davenport made a note of that, of who actually was the one who set Freezer Thompson up for the pin and that 1-2-3. Well, a lot of times folks call us and say, hey, how do I get involved? I want to be a wrestler. What do I do? Watch this.
The world-renowned USWA Wrestling Academy comes to Nashville, Tennessee. The wrestling school that has produced legendary professional wrestlers. Jerry the King Lawler, Tommy Wildfire, Huckstep Eddie Gilbert, The Rock and Roll Express, Jeff Jarrett, and more. Now you can attend the USWA Wrestling Academy at Fitness Trainers in Nashville and be trained by the best. Send for your application today to USWA Wrestling Academy, P.O. Box 1783, Hendersonville, Tennessee, 37077. Be sure to enclose a self-addressed stamped envelope. Learn to wrestle from the best. The USWA Wrestling Academy.
In the ring right now, we are set to go with a one-fall, 15-minute time limit match. We got the Invader going against the Young Gun. One-fall, 15-minute time limit. Frank Morrell says, ring him, and here we go.
Young Gun, Mike Mitchell. He's back in the USWA. Been around a little bit, back in the USWA in a single-fall bout today. One-fall, 15 minutes in time. The Young Gun tangled up with the Invader. Invader, push Young Gun into the turnbuckle. Whips the Invader into the turnbuckle. Drag drop on him, takes him down. Young Gun, a nice hip toss move there. Invader down again.
Great move right there. He grabbed the Invader's arm. The Invader still trying to regain his balance, and Young Gun gave him no opportunity. He just snapped him right back down to the mat.
Well, each time he just took the Invader down. Takes him now. Whips him into the ropes. Drop kick by Young Gun. Nice move, too.
Invader staggering back to his feet. Look at that. Look how quickly he's right back on him. He gets on his feet. The Invader mentally has got to be thinking, okay, I'm all right now, and boom, he's right back on the mat.
Not giving him much time at all to be stagnated in there. As soon as the Invader gets up on his feet, then Young Gun takes him right back down and going after that mask over there now. Man says, yeah, take it off. Young Gun reached for it again there. Invader trying to hold on to what he's got.
Yeah, the referee reminding Young Gun, you leave the mask alone. That's not the way to do it. By the way, every now and then in the picture in the background there, you just barely see her. That's Laura Davenport over there. She's making notes about this match, too.
Yeah, she's been out here taking notes again. I don't know what her final report or final analysis will be. I'd like to see that.
Yeah, you know, that probably would make some interesting reading. There's no doubt about it. Especially some of the people that she's talked about that she is she's making notes about.
Yeah, she's making notes about the fans over there, too.
Put down finest in the world, and that would
That's
be
right.
That would be the truth.
Mitchell, Young Gun with a nice flying press there. Took the Invader down. Follows with an elbow. Boy, Young Gun looks good. Two count on Invader. Invader kicked out of it.
I thought he had him right there. I was ready to ring the bell. It looked like Young Gun had him down for the count of three, but Invader's still alive after the two counts.
Yeah, nice backdrop there by Young Gun. Drop kick on the Invader. Takes him down. He's going for the pin cover. Every Frank Morrell tells him he's under the rope there, so that's a break for the Invader. Boy, he hadn't had many of those today.
Yeah, that's the one of the best moves he's made all day. Had his arm underneath that bottom rope.
Whoa. Young Gun follows down on the Invader. Got him in the middle of the ring now, set up for two. Invader won't go down. Only a two count that time.
Yeah, again, I thought he had him, but the Invader able to kick that shoulder just barely off the mat. Referee Frank Morrell said, nope, can't count him out. The shoulder's up.
Boy, what a big, powerful clothesline that time. But the Invader kicks up out of it again.
It's a pretty weak kick out, but he's keeping himself alive here.
Well, a reversal. Young Gun leaps over and comes back. What a big foot on the Invader. Cover now. Two. He got it that time.
Finally, the reverse kick is what did it, as Young Gun was able to nail the Invader and hold him down for the three count, as referee Frank Morrell told the count. And this one is all over. Give the victory, and a mighty good-looking one, to Young Gun. Back with more from the USWA after this. Tell you what, coming up Monday night, Mid-South Coliseum, you talk about action. We're
Ooh,
just looking at
yeah,
the card
Yeah, we were just
here.
Looking it over.
Man, seven matches on this card. 7:30 is when it all begins. Get ready, because the opening match of the night.
Opener.
Pat Tanaka will be going against Tony Falk in a ninja match. I'm going to try to get Tony out here a little bit later on and talk to him about this match a little bit. The kendo stick got involved last time around. Pat Tanaka against Tony Falk in the ninja match.
That's just the opener.
That's right.
That? Yeah.
Young Gun, you just saw him right here. Boy, he looked mighty good in the match when we just saw him here today.
Yeah.
And he will be going against someone who... he's got an attitude, but he's been able to back it up in the ring so far. Brian Christopher, what a match that ought to be.
Young Gun looked real good, but boy, he's got his hands full Monday night with Brian Christopher, I'll tell you that.
He's got his eye on that Texas title, too, which Brian Christopher is so proud of. And Young Gun, being from the Texas way, would love nothing better than to have that Texas title strapped around his waist. Southern title will be on the line in the next match, and this one... get ready, he's coming back. Handsome Jimmy Valiant will be going against Dr. Death with Nurse Kratchet in the corner. If somebody can get Jimmy on the phone, you better tell him bring one in bicycle helmets or motorcycle helmet or something with
you. Need it, yeah.
And stay away from Nurse Kratchett. Southern title on the line in that one. Then a grudge match. And boy, what a grudge this one is.
Yeah, this is going to be one. I can't wait to see Tony Anthony get his hands on Embry. Boy, isn't that horrible what Embry came out here and done earlier.
Embry just won't accept reality, hearing what he wanted to hear instead of what Kim, Dirty White Girl, was actually saying, and one of the most disgusting things we've ever seen
here.
Repeatedly.
Yeah, that's bad.
The grudge match, you don't have to put the word grudge match on this one. When Tony Anthony finds out what happened, he is going to come roaring in there looking for Eric Embry and nothing else in this match. Don't miss it. World Tag Titles will be on the line in the next one. The Moondogs with Richard Lee. We'll be going against the Fat Boy and Dr. Tom Prichard. Miss Texas will be in their corner. This one has the makings of fine tag team match. The Moondogs, of course, destroy everything in sight. They'll try to do it to the Fat Boy, Dr. Tom Prichard, but you got Prichard, who's a smart wrestler, and you got the Fat Boy, who is a very large, tough wrestler.
Also, would it be interesting, Miss Texas with Fat Boy and Prichard and Richard Lee with the Moondogs. So that'll be interesting. Richard Lee better look out. Miss Texas is a tough one.
She could help even it up on side. Then the World Unified Title match. We talked about it a little bit earlier. Coco Beware's got the title. He's going to defend it against Kamala. Kamala's manager said he would not let Kamala be partners with Coco Beware in a tag team match because he had to settle the World Unified Titles. Coco says, all right, that match will occur. Titles on the line. Then, main event of the night, eight-man tag team match. Stand by. On one side, you got the King. You got handsome Jimmy Valiant. You got Jeff Jarrett back from that back injury. And you got Kamala. What a team. And you look on the other side, you got the Moondogs. And in the ring again, you got Richard Lee.
Uh-huh.
And also returning from an injury, you got Big Black Dog. Eight of them, put them all in the ring. Will the ring hold up? That's the question.
Huh.
Will there be anything that's not nailed down at the Coliseum that will not be used as a weapon? That's another question. Monday night is when it all happens, 7:30 at the Mid-South Coliseum. Be there.
Big night.
Coming out right now, a couple of people who are going to be involved in the eight-man tag team match. There's the King, there's Jeff Jarrett. Boy, these two guys, you know, between the two of them, they can almost take on the four on the other side of the ring. But you put those partners with them in Kamala and handsome Jimmy Valiant, and you have an awesome tag team. I wonder if Lauren Davenport is taking due note over there of the popularity of these two gentlemen right here as they come around to the interview area.
Yeah, she needs to take a note of that one because, boy, these two have fans that really like the King and Jeff Jarrett.
King, that's quite a greeting from the fans there. We were just hoping this Lauren Davenport over there was taking note of that while she's out here. So let's kind of keep an eye on her. Jeff, welcome. Good to have you back after the injury.
I appreciate it, Dave. I'm feeling a lot better. You know, it's been a rough 2 weeks. I'm fixing to go to the doctor just in a few hours. I hope he's going to release me. He says if I keep making the progress that I've been making the past few weeks, that he will release me this afternoon. And Moondogs, I'm just going to say something. I'm going to make it short and sweet. I've laid on my back for 2 weeks. I couldn't even move. I've been through pain that I don't even want to talk about. It's the worst pain. And anybody out there who's had back pain, I guarantee one, they can attest to what I'm talking about. I've had more tests run on me, more x-rays, and I've laid it flat on my back, and I'm sick and tired of it. So you guys, you better get ready, because you're going to go through the exact same pain, and all I can say about Monday night is payback, and it's going to be 4-on-4. It ain't going to be 2-on-1, 3-on-1. It's going to be 4-on-4, and I promise you one thing. You're going to have the same pain that I went through.
All right, Jeff. Good to have you back again. King, that's an awesome team you guys have put together here.
Well, it is an awesome team. You know, I don't know. Can everybody hear us over there all right? No, I don't think they got the sound turned up loud enough in the studio. I want everybody to be able to hear what we're saying over here. First of all, that little bimbo over there ought to go somewhere and sit down because she's trying to get a little attention on herself. But let me tell her something. She wanted everybody to look at her. I heard that she went down to the beach in a bikini and even the tide wouldn't come in. So she might as well sit down somewhere because she ain't going to create no interest.
Now, let me talk about something that is interesting. I'm talking about a match that's going to have eight guys in it, and eight guys that don't... I'm not saying that these guys dislike each other. I'm not saying that these guys detest each other. I'm saying that these eight guys hate each other. I'm talking about the Moondogs and the Big Black Dog, and especially you, Richard Lee. You're going to all come out to the ring together, the four of you, the whole dog pound, all in one little pack of dogs, and you're going to be facing Jeff Jarrett, the King of Wrestling, Jerry Lawler, Kamala, the Uganda Giant, and handsome Jimmy Valiant. And I want to tell you something. I would put those four names up against any four individuals, not just in wrestling, but any four individuals in the world, pal. Now, we've had some matches in the past. This all started up in Missouri. Kennett, Missouri is where it all started, in the concession stand, but I think it's all going to end up this week right here in Memphis, Tennessee. Now, let me tell you guys, we've had some battles in the past. That's right. We fought all over the Coliseum. We fought all over the building. We fought in and out of the ring. But this week, with eight guys, I don't think the Coliseum's going to be able to hold it. And I know I've said this before. You've seen some wild matches. You've seen some crazy matches. But you ain't never seen nothing till you put Jeff Jarrett, the King, Kamala, and handsome Jimmy all together in one match. Moondogs, this is it, boys. This is the night that it's all going to happen. I promise you this. This is the night you're going to see all of those dogs leave with their tails tucked between their legs. Oh, yeah. And we're going to be whipping them right out of town.
All right. That's right.
Get you info. DWA. Tell all the ladies, handsome Jimmy's on his way. I'm a rocker and a roller. A little funky Jew. I was raised by a gypsy. You know, handsome's cool. I was born in New York City, San Francisco town. Tell all the women, handsome Jimmy's on the prowl. I'm a rocker and a roller. A little funky Jew. I was raised by a gypsy. That's why I had some Smokey Johnson. Woo! No time to talk.
Boogie Woogie Man, handsome Jimmy Valiant coming back into the area. Boy, I wish you were here right now, but instead, yeah, you see him. The Moondogs with Big Black Dog and the whistleblower himself, Richard Lee, leading the way.
Let me say something. Can you people all hear me over here all right? Can y'all hear me? Good. Well, shut up then, because I got something I want to say. Everybody comes out here week after week after week running their big fat mouths about what they're going to do to Richard Lee and my Moondog. Well, let me go down a list of something for you just a minute. Robert Fuller thought that he was going to put me and my dogs out of business. Robert Fuller is out of wrestling. Then you have Junkyard Dog, Austinite. Everybody wanted to come down and try and put Richard Lee's dogs out of business. Well, then everybody figured it out that Richard Lee controls the dogs. I got the meanest tag team in the world. The meanest. But everybody knows that if you hurt me, that you're going to hurt my dogs. I'm not a wrestler, people. But let me tell you something. A man can only be pushed in a corner for so long, and then it's all over. Well, brother, let me tell you something, Lawler. And let me tell you something, Jeff Jarrett. I know about back pain. And Jeff Jarrett, your back pain is from having to worm your way around and try and wipe that yellow streak off the middle of it. Jerry Lawler, you keep bringing all these people in here to get them hurt. Well, come Monday, come anytime, brother. Anytime down the road you want to come, come on down and bring anybody you want to. Jimmy Valiant, you call yourself the boogeyman? The only thing I know about boogie, buddy, is what goes in a handkerchief. And we're going to wrap you up in white cloth and ship you out, too. And anybody else that wants to come, come on down, people. As I told you once, Moondog Mountain's open and the rides don't last long. I'm fixing to unleash one of the worst powers in the history of professional wrestling right now. And boys, I want you to pay attention to what's fixing to happen in this ring. Because any night we get anywhere close to you people, it's going to happen. Boys, get him!
Well, Richard Lee sending them in there to do battle, and they jump their opponents immediately.
These guys, the Moondogs, Richard Lee's got them out here. One fall, Dave, in 15 minutes in time. Their opponents are Cousin John and Kevin Carson, their opponents. Oh, they're working these two young guys over there. Look out, look out. Moondogs inside of the ring working over Cousin John. Other Moondogs got Kevin Carson outside of the ring, and Richard Lee's holding that stupid metal chair. Rams him right into the thing over there. Moondog Spot grabs the chair. Oh, he slams Kevin Carson with that metal chair. Boy, boy, these... goes over and gets Cousin John. Richard, why don't you get the guys in the ring or either get them out of here? Boy, this is bad when they beat up on these guys. Watch it. Get that chair over there.
Oh. Look out.
Look out.
Both of them blasted over behind our desk here. Watch yourself, Corey.
Yeah.
Even the Moondogs using the World Tag Team belts. Referee Frank Morrell trying to get Richard Lee to take him out of here.
Come on, Lawler. Come on, Jim. Come on down, anybody that wants to take a ride on Moondog Mountain. Because this is the ride right here, baby. Anybody that thinks you got the guts, anybody thinks you got the nerve, come on and bring him. Any day of the week, any time of the month. I don't care. My dogs are ready. We don't back up from nobody, brother. Me included. I'm not a wrestler, but I can get in here and mix it up.
Richard Lee, I tell you, you need to get these guys out of here, Richard. Take them out of here.
Boy, one of the Moondogs looking around and even saw Richard Lee and looked at him weird.
Watch it over there, Davey.
Don't worry. I'm going to be behind this curtain if I have to.
Got the desk. There goes our desk again. He's beating Cousin John with that chair over there. Eddie Marlin's out telling Richard Lee to get him out of here. What he needs to do.
One of them has got one of these kids pinned under the desk here and standing on it. Here's Eddie Marlin. He's trying to get him out of here.
Hey, watch yourself, Eddie. Watch out. Watch these crazy guys.
Look out.
These guys are something else. I tell you, they come out here and we can just beat up on the opponents. Dave, that is... Watch it, Eddie. Watch it. Watch it. Swinging that chair over there.
Come on. Boy, even Eddie can't get him out of here this time. Richard Lee.
Richard.
Here's the thing. He can get him out of here when he wants to.
That's my point. Richard can get him out of here, but he won't take him out of here.
Let him run wild. Now finally
now
blows the whistle. He's pointing in that direction.
Watch it.
They got to come over and stand on this poor kid pinned under the table on the way out. All right, let's get out of here. Let's get the studio cleared out. We'll be back in a minute. We were just talking here. You were in Ripley, Tennessee last night with USWA action, and Ripley, Mississippi is coming up soon. Lots of other action, too. Tell us about it.
Yeah, lots of it coming up this Friday night. This coming Friday night, 7:30, Ripley, Mississippi at the high school there in Ripley, Mississippi this Friday night. The King, Jerry Lawler there, Jeff Jarrett, Moondogs on the card out there. Eric Embry, and look at that, Boogie Woogie Man, Handsome Jimmy. I'll be in Ripley, Mississippi. We'll all be out there this Friday night. I'll be there, special guest ring announcer. It's going to be a big night. Ripley, Mississippi, this Friday night. Bell time is 7:30. Holly Springs, Mississippi, coming up Friday, March 27th. Jonesboro, Arkansas, also coming up. Back to Jonesboro Sunday, March 28th. A lot of people lined up for Jonesboro at 8 o'clock there. Blyville, Arkansas, Thursday, April 2nd. Blyville, there at the National Guard Armory on Division Street. You see the lineup for Blyville, Arkansas, Thursday, April 2nd. Terrell, Arkansas, coming soon to Terrell. Friday night, April 3rd in Terrell. Going to be set up there at the Terrell High School. All of the USWA stars in Terrell, Arkansas. Coming up Thursday, April 9th, Clarksdale, Mississippi. We're out there this past Thursday night, Dave. Had a good crowd out in Clarksdale. Nice auditorium, too, Civic Auditorium. The Moondogs and Richard Lee will be out there. And a lot of people lined up for Clarksdale. And Kenton, Missouri, coming up Friday, April 10th. Boy, that's one of my favorite towns in Kenton, Missouri. Had that concession stand, the brawl. Boy, you're talking about action.
By the way, on Clarksdale, on the visual that we had right there, it had last Thursday's date, and there was wrestling in Clarksdale.
Right,
but it is going to come back to Clarksdale, and the new date is going to be April 9th. So you folks in the Clarksdale area, make your plans now to be there on Thursday, April 9th. Next time around in Clarksdale, Mississippi. Crowds have been great around the USWA.
Yeah, good crowds last night in Ripley, Tennessee, and Thursday night in Clarksdale.
Big crowd here today. Looking for a big crowd, of course, at the Coliseum come Monday night. One of the matches Monday night at the Coliseum is going to be a match in which a kendo stick figured prominently. Now, the match was actually Eric Embry against Pat Tanaka. Tony Falk was around, though. Take a look at what happened.
White girl, he's got the kendo stick, jumps in the ring. Tanaka, oh, he caught it right in the throat with that thing. Tony Falk comes running out here. Hey, Tony! Boy, I tell you. Referee Frank Morrell, he's still stumbling. He's not up on his feet yet. Just rolls over against the two and the three.
I think you just barely got the idea of what was going on here. The kendo stick held by Tony Falk came in and nailed Pat Tanaka with it, and as a result, you saw what happened at the end of that match. Well, there has been a ninja match signed. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, boy.
Well, I wanted to talk to him about it, but I don't believe what I'm looking at here. Here's Tony Falk. Tony looks like...
Look out there.
Don't be swinging too much. Let's talk. Let's talk about it. You're all obviously decked out for the ninja match coming up.
Let me tell you something, Dave Brown. Pat Tanaka, boy, listen up good. You see what happened to you the last time you tried to mess with Tony Falk? I took that kendo stick, and I stuck it right down your throat. But let me tell you something. This time, I'm going to take that stick, but I'm going to stick it the other end. Right up the... And let me tell you something. I've been sharpening my skills. You didn't know it, but I'm a master at this kind of match. You wait till I get my hands on you, Pat Tanaka, and you're going to wish you never signed to wrestle Tony Bruce Lee Falk in a ninja match. You heard it, Corey.
Tony Bruce Lee Falk with a ninja match coming up. Oh, it's been signed. It's going to be him against Pat Tanaka. Look out for that one. We'll be back in a moment. Dr. John Prichard. Their opponents are already here. The very confident Brian Christopher, the Texas champion, and his partner, Tony Falk. This one has the makings of a super tag team match. And we got it for you right here today on the USWA. Christopher up in the ring. Oh, I see. Miss Texas there.
Doing the twist along with him.
Yeah. Just that. Doing the twist. And Dr. Tom Prichard talking to Brian Christopher.
Potato, the fat boy. Oh, he's got somebody to do the twist with him there.
Yeah.
She twisted right back to his seat there.
You're absolutely right.
Miss Texas got a lot of fans in. Want to twist along with her out there. Dr. Tom Prichard along ringside.
A lot of celebrating going on at ringside before this match. Starting to get a little steamed in the ring is Brian Christopher. He's starting the insult saying, come on, we got a wrestling match. You guys get in the ring here. And that boy. A couple of more greetings. And now heads back in the general direction of his corner. Tom Prichard and Tony Falk. These two have bumped into each other before.
Oh, yeah.
And we are just about set to go, I think, as tag team action will be getting underway.
Christopher and Falk doing all of that talk in the ring, and when Fat Boy and Prichard stepped inside of the ring, boy, they went flying out of there. Tony Falk yelling some words to the fans. Ryan Christopher, I guess he's going to start things off to his side. Referee Kevin Christian trying to get things cleared out on the other side. We'll see. He's going to start things off over there with Miss Texas along ringside with him. Going to be the Fat Boy, Potato. Kevin Christian says ring the bell, and here we go. Tag team action on USWA Championship Wrestling, Dave.
Hold on to your hat. This one should be a good one. Fat Boy, Brian Christopher. What a way to get it started, huh? And the Texans over in the corner, Tony Falk and Dr. Tom Prichard. And yet another Texan and Ms. Texas over in the corner, Dr. Tom Prichard and the Fat Boy.
This is set to be a good one. Tag team action. Oh, Christopher telling the Fat Boy stay out of his hair over there. Tato saying, no, I didn't touch his hair.
And he didn't. That is a tactic, and it can be a very effective one. What Brian Christopher is trying to do is to get the referee thinking, maybe he did pull his hair. I didn't see it, but maybe he did. I better watch him more closely. And you take the focus to your opponent, and maybe you can get away with something.
That's true. Oh! He slapped Potato, and Potato, Fat Boy, he counted with a lick of his own on Brian Christopher.
He wasted no time in doing it either. He just, all of a sudden, it was automatic. Pow, he popped him and knocked him right down to the mat. Brian Christopher's stunned. He can't believe anybody would do that to him.
Christopher set to go.
You wait to Brian.
He's in the ring with Fat Boy Potato. Tangling up with the Fat Boy now. Grabs that arm, twisting his arm. Potato twisting that arm again. Oh, reversal. Fat Boy working over that arm. Brian Christopher tags his partner. Dr. Tom Prichard wraps it out of Houston, Texas, the holder of the Southern Heavyweight title. Look at Christopher over there. Wraps his leg around the rope.
He is hanging onto that rope. There's no doubt about it. He wanted to make no mistake about it that he was in the rope so that the referee would send Tom Prichard back away. These two have met before, too.
Oh, yeah. He got a break in the action that time. It's certainly what he needed because Dr. Tom was going after him, working on the arm of Christopher now. Oh, reversal. Nice takedown by Prichard. Oh, you see Christopher pull his hand there.
Yep, yanked a handful. Oh, Prichard came up with a fist doubled up. The referee stepped right in front of him, though, and said, fist open. You want to see it?
Prichard's got Christopher in the headlock move there. Christopher takes Dr. Tom into the ropes. Prichard comes back over, leaps over, comes over again, and hip toss on Christopher. Nice move there. And Dr. Tom Prichard.
Christopher wants a tag. Yeah, get me out of here, he says. Here comes Tony Falk. Don't sell him short. I know sometimes we laugh about some of the things he says and the outfit he shows up in, but this guy can be dangerous.
He's a veteran. He is. Tony Falk. Tangling out by Dr. Tom Prichard. Oh, he caught Prichard right in the throat with a chop there. Top of the head of Prichard. Oh, caught him in the throat again.
Yep, point of the fingers. He jabbed him in the throat.
Reversal. Prichard takes Falk. In the turnbuckle and the backdrop on Tony Falk. Oh, chop of his own now by Prichard. Whips Falk into the ropes now. Catches him again with another big chop. Tony Falk back up on his feet and Tom Prichard and Fat Boy Potato working together well, and Potato drops down on the arm of Tony Falk. Whips Falk back into the ropes. In the midsection, he caught him. Oh, what a move. Right, Fat Boy Potato took Tony Falk down from behind. Brian Christopher broke the hold there, interfering in the match. He's going after Potato now. Breaks the eyes of Fat Boy, catches him with a right hand. That's Brian Christopher. He is some kind of wrestler. Holder of the Texas heavyweight title, and oh, he's got a lot of mouth to go along with it, too. Reversal here, Christopher in the turnbuckle. Boy, what a lot of weight down on Brian Christopher. Slowed Christopher down, whoops him again. Oh, potato found a big foot that time by Brian Christopher.
Boy, give Christopher some credit reluctantly on that. That was a good move.
Shut up, you falling down on Fat Boy. Christopher holds him up. Oh, that potato comes out. Two count. Oh, he only got two, though. Thought he may have had him. Brian Christopher tried to set Potato up for a body slam, which is the same thing Tony Falk's trying to do. This time, Fat Boy rolls Falk up for the cover, two. Only two out of that one. Falk snapped out of some kind of way before he had Tony rolled up.
Once again, Fat Boy and Tom Prichard very close to a victory here, just not quite able to get the count of three. But I tell you what, the action continues. Look at Christopher choking Fat Boy with a rope over here.
Yeah, he's over there choking him. He and Tony Falk double-teaming Fat Boy Potato. Potato in the...
I heard Falk yell, "We tagged," which tells me they didn't. I didn't see a tag, did you?
I didn't see one.
No, I think Brian just walked in there.
Brian Christopher grabs Potato. Slugs him with a right hand. Oh, Potato coming back with a fist of his own. And standing up with Brian Christopher. Christopher slugs him at Potato. Fighting his way back. Whips Christopher into the ropes now. Oh, power slam. What a good move, boy. Only two Falk broke it up. But I tell you, Dave, this Potato, he's got a lot of energy. He's got some great moves, too. He's a big guy, but he can really move around real quick.
You called it exactly right. He has impressed me with his ability to move around the ring. And keep in mind, he's going against the Texas champion. And they didn't just hand him that belt. It was a little controversial the way Christopher won it. But this guy's a tough wrestler. And look at these two going at it. That's why all the crowds have been so big in the USWA lately. You see action like this.
That's right. Great action it is in the USWA again today. Brian Christopher, the Texas champion, and Fat Boy Potato. Boy, these two have been going after each other. Christopher tags his partner, Tony Falk. Our time is going. We're almost out of time, I think.
Yeah, it's a 10-minute time limit, and we are just about at that time limit, like within seconds right now. Time is expired.
It.
It's a 10-minute time limit match, and it is up. Time is up. And, boy, I hate that, because what some kind of action we have had in this one. We've got to take a break as they continue. We'll be back after this. Tell you what, Lauren Davenport, the note taker, remains in the studio here, and
getting
sort of an
time,
unscientific poll has just been going on, and we've determined that nobody likes her. So there she is right there. She doesn't seem to be fazed by it, unfortunately. Yeah, there's the reaction of the crowd when she appears right there. Tell you what, come Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum, we're expecting a great crowd for tremendous
big
wrestling
night.
Action.
Yes, sir.
Seven matches. Look at the opener. He had Pat Tanaka going against Tony Falk. This is that ninja match. You've already seen Tony. He was decked out in that kickboxing outfit and the headgear and all that sort of stuff. He'll be going against Pat Tanaka.
He's going to need all of that and more when Tanaka gets a hold of him, too, I guarantee you.
I think you're right. Texas title match coming up then. Brian Christopher, the champion, will be putting that belt on the line against Young Gun. Young Gun looked mighty good in his match here today. He'll challenge for the belt. And being from Texas, you know he'd love nothing more than to be riding around here with it around his waist. Southern heavyweight title will be on the line then. Handsome Jimmy Valiant, the Boogie Woogie Man, is going to be challenging for that belt. Dr. Death with Nurse Kratchet and the bedpan in the corner in there.
Yeah, Jimmy better look out for that, but I know the Boogie Woogie Man can hold his own.
After what happened earlier today, I don't have to even say too much about this one, except look out, Eric Embry. Dirty white boy Tony Anthony has been released by the doctor. He will be back in action Monday night at the Coliseum. Dirty White Girl Kim will be in the corner, and after what Embry did today, that disgusting display that Embry put on here today, Tony Anthony is going to come looking for him, and he may just literally tear him apart right there in the Coliseum, and I think a lot of us will be cheering him on if he does.
I'll be glad to see it.
World Tag Titles on the line then. The Moondogs with Richard Lee going against it. Boy, this team looks good.
Yes, sir.
Bad Boy and Dr. Tom Prichard with Miss Texas. You certainly cannot count them out of the match, and as you, Corey, pointed out a little bit earlier, Richard Lee has been the difference in these Moondog matches in many cases. Well, he got Miss Texas over in their corner. That could even it up. World Tag Titles on the line. Then the World Unified Title will be on the line. Coco Beware will be challenged by Kamala, the former world champion, the Ugandan giant, trying to take the title back. And then the main event, standby eight-man tag team match. Four on each side. On one side, you got the King. You got handsome Jimmy Valiant. You got Jeff Jarrett returning from an injury. And you got Kamala.
What a team, boy.
And then on the other side, you got the Moondogs. Richard Lee back in the ring. And Big Black Dog also returning from an injury. I think Jerry Lawler said it all a little bit earlier. A lot of these guys don't like it. A lot of these guys hate each other. And with the given the destruction left by the Moondogs from time to time, and as he said, it all began in Kennett, Missouri, it might end Monday night
at the
Mid-South Coliseum. 7:30 is when it all begins. Big card coming up there.
Oh, yeah.
We'll be back with more right here after this. The other night, named Barry McGuire, who about 25 years ago or so had a song out called The Eve of Destruction. And every time that the Moondogs run through a place, it's not the eve, it reminds me the morning after destruction.
Oh.
And Randy West has put together sort of a video compilation, sort of a whole group of things that the Moondogs have destroyed. Take a look.
If you ever put another stitch in one of my dog's heads, you're going to pay for it tenfold, brothers. And now the war has started.
Lawler's got that. Oh, boy, look out. Thing of glass. Hey, look out. Boy, he almost caught the Moondog with that glass. Let me get back here so I can see what's going on. Oh, man, what a wild bout. There goes a light bulb in the top of the kitchen there. That's the Moondog with that trash can again that Richard Lee initially brought to the ring that started this whole wild bout.
Robert Fuller felt like he could come in with a church key and try and cut my dog. It didn't happen that way. We got the church key away from Robert Fuller, and we showed him what it's like. He kept sticking his nose in our business. We ended his career. I don't care what anybody says. Robert Fuller will never come back. I've trained my dog, Jeff Jarrett, always wrestle by the rules. Always wrestle clean, Jeff Jarrett. That's it. So what happened? You've been the spoiled little brat that you are, Jeff Jarrett. We win the match. We get the belt. We're leaving the ring. And you pick up a steel chair, Jeff Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett and Robert Fulk. Did Jerry Lawler decide that he's going to stick his big nose into our business? Well, let me tell you what, boys. You can go out here and you can get anything you want to. Get anybody you want to, huh?
I don't know. Get that big metal now.
talk about big. Boy, he is right.
This Dave Brown is my new dog. This is my big black dog, Dave Brown. And when you got to take care of business, you go out and you find somebody big to help you take care of business. Because, Betty, let me show you something. Get a close-up of this arm. Get a close-up right here, baby. Because I promise, Jerry Lawler, Jeff Jarrett, anybody else you want to bring, brother, any folks you want to bring, I'm going to promise you one thing. My dogs are going to leave you with broken bones, baby. Broken bones.
Big crowd in the Memphis Mid-South Coliseum, Memphis, Tennessee. And the Coliseum boys already torn up. We're not 5 minutes into the bout. Lawler's got that big tin trash can, throwing it out to the big black dog. He's just blocking that cannon. Going after Lawler, throws a chariot after him. Outside of the ring, Jeff, whoa, caught with a big clothesline by the big black dog. Oh, Richard Lee goes and grabs another trash can. Looks like a new one. Boy, he did that can on Lawler.
My dog! We're mad now. It's Armageddon time, and I want everybody concerned to pay attention to what's fixing to happen in this ring right now, because every time we get within 10 feet of anybody, this is what's going to happen. Sit down.
It's bad for them to come out here. Oh. Richard, why don't you get them out of here? I'm telling you. Boy, that's hard. Beat these guys like that. Turn that table over. On Dazzler Hayes. Boy, this is hard, the way they beat these young
Once
guys.
Once again, the Moondogs running wild out here.
Yes. Well, let me show you something. Bart was supposed to get his stitches out today. I was going to do that. Today, you know what I got to do? I got to take Bart and get his stitches out, Bart. And you know what? Because you boys keep wanting to come to the ring, and you want to carry.
Because I'm tired of it. I'm tired of seeing the stitches in my dog's head. I'm tired of seeing you trying to break my dog's bones.
Richard, why don't you get him out of here? Boy, that doesn't make any sense. They got the 1-2-3 pin cover, and they won't get him out of here for what reason? What in the world is this? Here comes Kamala. He's got a door in here. What in the world? Kamala's attendant grabs the door, gives it to Kamala.
Day. We say that a lot, but my goodness gracious, did we have some action here today.
Oh, indeed.
Boy, that opening thing, a disgusting thing with Eric Embry and Dirty White Girl.
Oh, it was,
in that bag.
Tony Anthony will take care of that situation, believe me. Embry did win his match. And then Dr. Death, Nurse Kratchet came in, the bedpan figure in a match again. Young Gun looked mighty good in his match.
Looked real good. And the Moondogs didn't get a 1-2-3 today. The bout was stopped because they just beat up on Cousin John and Kevin Carson. Boy, they beat those two young guys.
And then the final match of the day. What a match.
Good match.
I wish we'd had a lot more time because the time ran out. It was a 10-minute time limit match. Fat Boy and Dr. Tom Prichard against Brian Christopher and Tony Falk. We're out of time right here.